That's Funky Boy to your left. in hell are you from anyway, Private? Sir, Texas, sir!
Prescribe your pharmacist to assist in catching the vibes. And take two, for four. The questions asked and answered, yes, y'all. A double dose came to liven up the scene to keep the whole crowd moving off the ill routine. I took two pills of skills and on the rails from my pocket spent 16 bills. Followed the warning in the morning. I woke up all choked up and broke up. Kissed my practice, gone practice on top of tables. The label said something about some side effects. We're catching wreck, plus the gain of respect from all my peers. Cheers, coming from stands, hands from the rap fans could possibly clap to make noise. Boys with the prefix B will strictly windmill and up rock with flares and whatnot. Bust beats hitting replay, loved by the DJ. You may catch referrals from murals of a writer. Warning, when I create a rap superstar, may cause depression cause your sales ain't up to par. It's far-fetched, so I sketch my words to represent. I'm not just a client, I'm the president. So take two, and mind you gotta give a call. The questions asked and answered, yes, y'all. A double dose, pill from the ill prescribed. Your pharmacist who assisted catching the vibes. So take two, and mind you gotta give a call. The questions asked and answered, yes, y'all. A double dose, came to liven up the scene to keep the whole crowd moving off the ill routine. There's too many MCs, not enough mics to talk to. B, you're not two, B, it's three, minus one for the definition. It's also an after mic check, one. Too many MCs rocking the same flow. The number to tango, it's night and it's Play-Doh. We're terrible twos from Tuesday till Tuesday. We're scratching off our to-do list, so touche and too brute. Take two, and mind gotta give a call. The questions asked and answered, yes, y'all. A double dose, pill from the ill prescribed. Your pharmacist who assisted catching the vibes. So take two, and mind gotta give a call. The questions asked and answered, yes, y'all. A double dose, came to liven up the scene to keep the whole crowd moving off the ill routine. Take two, and mind gotta give a call. The questions asked and answered, yes, y'all. A double dose, pill from the ill prescribed. Your pharmacist who assisted catching the vibes. So take two, and mind gotta give a call. The questions asked and answered, yes, y'all. A double dose, came to liven up the scene to keep the whole crowd moving off the ill routine.
I'm Matt Holgan. I'm 28 years old, been riding almost 18 years from Macon, Georgia, recently Atlanta.
My name's Mitch Hall. I've been riding 4.5 years. I'm 23 years old.
My name is Shane Kajanori. I'm 16 years old, and I've been riding for 2.5 years.
My name is Jeff Foster. I'm 30 years old, live in Atlanta, Georgia, 30 South. Been riding off and on 17 years.
Name's John Dowker, AKA The Duke. Originally from Peterborough, Ontario, Canada. Now I reside in Athens, Georgia.
Hi, I'm Kent Pearson, Athens, Georgia. I've been riding for 17 years now. I've been married for 5 years now, and I have a 20-month-old son named Mason, and he loves to ride.
Hi, my name's Jody Temple. I'm 27 years old. I ride Flatland, and I live in Athens, Georgia. I ride for Dragonfly, which I just got hooked up with, Harvest Clothing, which is Anthony Durbano's new clothing company, and Sunshine Cycles here in Athens, Georgia.
I don't know, I feel kind of weird. I came up with the name Flatland Manifesto when I was trying to do a print magazine like so many other people have, and like so many other Flatland specific print magazines that went down in a ball of flames. So I was pretty stoked when Nev wanted to use the name, because I was fond of the name and I didn't want to see it just die right there. Also, I'm the art director for Flatland Fuel. I design their logos and their shirts and do their commercials and stuff, and that's terrific because I work in a crappy sort of corporate job where I have to do pie charts and stuff. So Pat Schoolin lets me do a lot of really cool stuff for his company without, you know, really putting any sort of weird constraints on it. I can do almost anything I want, so that's a pretty good deal. Nestone, man, that guy, I don't know what makes him ride that way. He's just crazy. He's probably the most talented rider here in Atlanta, I think. I guess we can't really take much credit for it. He was good when he came here, he was good when he left, and he was good when he came back. Nestone will have anybody just drive by. He has no problem walking up to him and saying, hey man, you cannot park here. I'm riding here. And people leave. I don't know if he's just intimidating or what. He's the nicest guy, but I've never seen anybody just walk up to total strangers and go, oh, you can't park your car here. I'm riding my bike.
Metro, we do it like this right here. I'll tell y'all the secret about this, because this is like a W, but to us, if you turn it upside down, it's an M, just so we know what it is and y'all don't, but I guess y'all do now.
Jeff's really, he's a really, really good rider, I think. He kind of pushes me to do more creative stuff, you know, as far as in like more rolling stuff rather than scuffing a lot and stuff like that. And he's a really fun guy to be with, just hang out with and have a good time.
First met like some guys from Atlanta about 5 years ago, and more or less just take turns, you know, most of the time they wind up coming riding here. I think because we have a more centralized spot and everybody in Atlanta, it's really separated. And it's hard to like to get everybody together to ride sometimes and have a good central spot.
Scene in Athens rocks. Just totally willing to like accept me for who I was, and real tight knit group of guys. Used to be a really good street scene here. It's just like I could tell these guys were gonna be my best friends.
You know, it was good to live here, but and rode here for a couple years by myself. But since then, it's really grown into a large scene where everybody loves coming here, and I love staying here. And I don't think I'm really ever gonna go anywhere else but Athens.
Jody has always been good since the first time I came down here with '96 or something. He was tearing it up. He's just real dedicated. He rides every day. He knows what he loves, Flatland, and he just wants to progress.
I grew up in a little town like called Hartwell that's about 45 miles outside of Athens, but Athens was always sort of the center of like the Flatland in this area, and I met Kent like when I was really early, so I used to always come here to ride like all the time on the weekends and stuff, like starting when I was like about 14 or 15, and as soon as I started being able to drive, I was coming over here all the time. Kent's completely my mentor. I honestly have no idea where I would be in bike riding without him. Like, I met him when I was like 14 years old, and him and I were basically the only two people in this area that kept on riding bikes. Like, right after I met him is when all my friends quit, and his friends quit too. And we lived about 15 miles from each other, and in like different towns, we went to different high schools, and he was a few years older than me, but he'd always come and ride with me on the weekends and pick me up, carry me to contests. So, and him and I have just always pushed each other and kept each other into it. We've been riding together almost 13 years now.
Athens family kind of came around as a joke. I rode here for a couple of years by myself, and then more and more riders moved into town, and the more we rode here, the more new guys picked up and came into town. And after a while, people started pointing out that we didn't really act like just riding buddies around each other. It wasn't all about riding. We were more like a family. And there was this old pinball machine, an Adams family pinball machine, and one day somebody made the joke that it should be an Athens family machine, and after that it kind of stuck, and it kind of at random people would show up and be like, hey, how's the Athens family? And then after that it just kind of stuck on, and we wear it really proudly now. We take it pretty seriously, tattoos and the whole bit. Everybody really takes the Athens family thing as serious as they would a real family. I always knew my heart was in Athens. It's got a really good vibe here, riding and otherwise. To live here or to ride here, either one, is just the best feeling vibe I've ever felt out of anywhere that I've been.
I really like Atlanta, though. I think this is my home for now. Probably always will be.
Place to be. It's like Southern California weather, but European style, not like a staticky governing or anything. You can just kind of do whatever you want and be on your own improve and nobody really bothers you. And food's good, it's cheap, people are great, there's lots of riders. Well, I haven't really lived anywhere, but kind of lived, I guess. Pretty much the only place I've really lived has been LA, Athens, and Spain. The rest has just kind of been a blur of places. I don't want to be in the same place for too long. I mean, I don't know. That's just the way I am. I guess I get burned out on things and like to see new things and always check out new places. And that kind of always kept me going and always kept me motivated, was going to new places and learning new things and seeing new people and hearing different, you know, just change of scenery, really. Might be hard for a mother because her son's never there and just kind of takes off. And she always kind of insinuates that she wishes she would have traveled more when she was younger, when she had the chance. And she did her share, and she's always been positive with me about what I do. And I've always liked taking photos ever since I was little. I just had like a cheap little camera, whatever, and a few years ago I went to Japan and bought a really nice Canon with a couple nice lenses, so been taking it along with me for all my travels and getting some good shots of all kinds of different places and things. Yeah, I play a little bit. I used to play a lot, like, not to say that I'm good or anything. I've done well sometimes, you know, betting or whatever, but I used to play a lot, yeah. Phil Dolan, oh. We played probably as much pool as we rode last winter. Like, see, we'd go ride and then we'd go play pool and then we'd go out. It was like every day for a couple months. Definitely there's a contest aspect. It's tense and stressful. And the feeling of when after a contest, and if you do well, you know, that's a pretty good feeling that you're able to continue riding and make money and keep make a living doing it, doing something you like, and get to travel for it, and you know, I don't know. And I've always just like had that kind of outlook. Like, if you enjoy doing a trick, then, you know, do it. You know, I don't know what anybody thinks. If someone thinks it's stupid, well, you like doing it, right? You know what I mean? There's stuff that I probably still do and I've been doing for a long time, but I like doing it. You know what I mean? And I'm not worried about like, oh, I did that. I like doing it. You know. There's obviously goals and short-term, long-term goals, but priorities of life are, for me, having fun and not getting too down on anything, which is hard to do sometimes. I know for anybody probably, but try to stay positive and look at the future in a good way, even though sometimes difficult in the world we live in to look at things positively and look at the world in a positive way. But try. I'd like to say thanks to a lot of people and everybody I think that's helped me out along the way, or wherever I've been knows who they are, so thank you. And to my sponsors, actionshoesbizhouse.com. That's it. We'll be right back.
In today's how-to for FM5, we are going to show you the Megaspin. This was invented by Jason Parks a long time ago, and people had no idea what he was doing. Initially, to do this Megaspin, you must need momentum. A good way to pick up momentum is by carving your front wheel into it, and then just lifting up and start kicking the tire. It's that easy. One thing I can note to you, though, to make the trick a little bit smoother and savvier is turning your handlebars a little bit. This is going to help you look over your shoulder a little bit behind you. This is going to keep you rotating. You have to lean your bike during a regular mega spin. That's going to keep your true center. G-turn mega spin involves no kicking. You're just pumping your body, going from forward to backward, trying to get as many G-turns in as possible. To do the G-turn mega spin involves a lot of momentum and a lot of pumping. So you have to push and pull on the bike. Try it for a while, you'll find out exactly what works best for you. I find that just aiming yourself into the way you want to huck it just seems to be the best way. It'll smooth itself out. Playing with variations on your mega spin can be very important to your combos, like throwing in a cross up, maybe switch foot it, or on the top tube. Here's the bar spin. Basically, I just grab hold of the seat, keeping that centered lock with my bike leaned over to keep the center, and grab on the seat, give it a huck. The X up mega spin makes your bars face forward. Pretty much a regular mega spin, just try and keep your X up as tight as possible. That way you're not leaning your body all off the side and cockeyed. Spinning lawnmower involves rolling into the trick, locking into a sweet spot where your circle is. Once you get through, you stick your leg through, and you'll find yourself spinning like a pirouette. All about getting that sweet spot. The bike has to be straight up and down. Biggest thing is don't reach for your bike. Pull it up to you.
el Manuel de Costa Rica me contó una broma hace una semana. Va así. ¿Cómo se dice papel higiénico en chino? A ver si sabes. Quita caquita.